Welcome into Pioneer Basketball with Devin Carters. The Tusculum Pioneers opened up the 2017-18 season and probably didn't blow some minds, at least this guy's mind, but the Pioneers have played extremely well all season long. Joined by Pioneer Basketball, Devin Carter. This is a Pioneer Basketball team. As we take a look at 2018, we turn the calendar year. When we look at some of the numbers and how we have won games and how we have been so good, we've built leads based on our ability to rebound, and I think you call it a toughness for this basketball team. Is it the fact that they're getting more comfortable with you, or that you're recruiting kids that can compete in the South Atlantic Conference?
Well, I think it's a combination of both. You know, when I got into coaching, when I first became a head coach, my college coach said, you win by toughness and rebounding. And so that's always kind of stuck with me. And, you know, looking back over the past, you know, few years, my first year, I really wasn't able to bring in anybody. And then, you know, last year, we were finally able to get our foot down and go out and get some kids. It's one of the main things I look for was toughness. And, you know, because I've been through the league enough to know that when you play your LMUs and your Wingates, you got to have that to be able to compete. So I think it's a combination of us just really, really emphasizing it every single day and then having kids with the ability to go get it done.
Well, more than half, almost three quarters of your points this year and your minutes are played by newcomers, but you still have the likes of KJ, Callie Patterson, Sydney Wilson, those kids who have been with you from the beginning. But what has the mix been like, and did it take long for you to get a chemistry with this group?
You know what? Surprisingly, we kind of got lucky with this group. We have a lot of kids who have infectious personalities. Mm-hmm. They're very outgoing. They're very tight group. So it took a little while. I think the big thing was, you know, being able to get those kids in here early. A lot of those kids were here in summer school working with our strength coach. So that was really big because they were able to hang out with each other before the year started, before classes started and stuff like that. So they were really on campus. It was just them and the football players. So it was good for them to get together and bond, and they would get in the gym and get up shots with each other. So I felt like that was really, really big. And then, you know, once we started the conditioning aspect, when you're going through preseason and you're doing some of that shared suffering a little bit, you have no choice but to kind of come together. When I was at Hargrave, it said that the tough times build a camaraderie, and that's definitely what happened with us this year.
All right, listen, it's a six-win team from a year ago, already doubled that this season and competing in the top four in the South Atlantic Conference. How did they get there? Let's take a look at some of that action that has gone on. We'll start really here in 2018. Coach, you turned the calendar year, went to Mars Hill, got off to a very good start in 2018, then went to LR, a place that was extremely tough to win, had Carson Newman. The first three to turn the calendar year challenged you in different ways, and I think it showed you a lot about your team.
For sure. You know, like, we go to Mars Hill, and you expect to see one lineup, and then you see another lineup for them. They came out and played five guards, and so, you know, one of the things has been, you know, one of our strong points this year is our post play and our ability to rebound the basketball. Then all of a sudden, you're having to put five guards on the floor, which, you know, we never do. You know, we never simulate that in practice. So we had to adjust to that. Felt like the kids responded well. You know, we were able to get that game up and down, you know. So that was definitely a different look. And then you go to LR, who is, you know, I think the toughest gym to play in the league. You know, you go there and you don't know what you're going to get. You're always expecting the worst, but I knew that with the group we had this year, you know, I know how hard they play and compete. So I felt like, you know, as long as we went down there and competed, we were going to have a chance to win the ball game. So, you know, was really proud of that effort, especially in the first half. Didn't get off to a great start, but we defended at a really high level, and that kept us in the ball game until we were finally able to make some shots.
Carson Newman came. They show why they're one of the top teams in the country. And then we start this little homestand with them, obviously, but then you play two teams that you've had zero success against in Newberry and Anderson, except for one game. I don't want to say it was an eye-opening experience for me, but it was definitely a season changer through those two with Meg Essex and the ability for them to slow the game down. And even though they slowed you down, you still found ways to win.
Yeah, you know, I tell people all the time, I think Newberry, probably on the offensive end of the floor, is probably one of the best in the league. They force you to guard for 30 seconds, and then they end up getting the shot they want anyway.
Yeah.
And, you know, over the years, you know, they've been so good. They've always been in that top four in our league. They usually only play six or seven people, so they slow the game down. And you really have to be disciplined to play any success against them. And so, you know, to get that one at home was very big for us. And I think it was very big, you know, for some of our juniors who never had that experience of beating them. But, you know, to be able to close that game out, finish the game the right way, I think was huge. And I think that was a big step for us moving forward.
You know, Anderson, to me, was that game that you really saw a lot, because that was more than 20. That was getting the job done in the fast break, turning them over, and then slowing it down and getting, as you call, those cheap buckets inside, as the emergence of Kendrea Duke has obviously been big, you know, for this team as well. That was almost a high, and I'll talk about maybe what happened after that, but that was, it seems to be the high of the season. Would I be wrong there?
Yeah, I mean, that was a big one. I think that, you know, especially for our older kids and kids who have been in the league, they know the Andersons and the LMUs and, you know, the Wingates and teams like that. But, you know, at the time, Anderson was, and still are, they're one of the best defensive teams in the country. And they make it so tough for you to score. And I think that was a big win for us, because we were able to hop on them early.
Yeah.
And then, you know, the thing about it is teams like that don't go away. And so sometimes as a coach, you're kind of leery when you hop out on teams like that, because you expect the lull to come. And we just kind of stayed the course. We defended really well. We rebounded really well. And that, you know, is what kind of concerned me going into that game, because they're so big and they're so athletic. But we were able to control the glass, and our press was really, really effective. And so no doubt that was a huge win for us, because now all of a sudden, instead of playing in games that don't matter, you're playing in some games that are truly, truly important. And that stretch was big for us, because, you know, you got to protect home court. And now it sets up the second half of the year where you got to go on the road and get yourself.
Problem is, with the second half of the year, teams have seen you. And that's what happened when we turned around, went to Harrogate just a little bit. They came out with a different passion. We didn't match their intensity, I think. And I think a little bit of that was also with the Catawba game. Was it a fact that maybe a coach, you know, when you take a look at Evans and Morton and how the job that they do in recruiting as well, they also break down some tape. Did they see us and take away some things that we like to do?
No. Just being honest, I felt like, you know, we went up to Harrogate, and make no mistake, you know, great ball club. You're on the road. They beat a lot of really good teams there. They protect their home floor, beat Southern Indiana, top 25 team there at their place. But I feel like, you know, in that game at LMU, I think we shot ourselves in the foot. We came out to the slow start, and the thing that I've learned with this group is slow starts, you know, happen sometime. But they're a resilient group. Mm-hmm. So, you know, we were down 11-0, I think, in that game. And I never burned a timeout, because I know, like, you know, they've earned the rope to be able to fix it. And they did. If I'm not mistaken, we were winning at the half or down by one at the half. They're a very tough group and resilient. But we missed so many cheap ones around the bucket. And then, you know, with me along being in foul trouble that entire game, for us to even have a shot down the stretch, I was proud of our team, but at the same time, you can't miss free throws and you can't miss two-foot shots. Yeah. And so I felt like, you know, LMU played a great game, but I felt like that onus was on us. You know, when you go on the road, you got to make everything count. And the thing that I was disappointed in is just that, you know, we kind of beat ourselves on that one. And, you know, in South Atlantic Conference play, you can't do that.
It's a team then that had the week off after the Catawba loss to get healthy and get ready, and then we get sick.
Yeah.
We don't get a chance to play Wingate. We'll make that game up on the 19th of February. So now going into this, I guess now official second half of the season, you open up with Mars Hill, but that means you'll have the number one and number two team in our league in a less than a seven-day stretch to close out the season, plus finish on the road four of the last six, where you'll finish on the rope. So I think this is it, you know, for your team as far as preparing, getting ready.
Yeah.
We'll see their mental toughness, I think, here down the final month of the season.
For sure. And you know what? It's one of those things where, you know, you mentioned, you know, the year and the second time around. So many things go into, you know, the league and how the standings shake out. You know, some teams have injuries.
Yeah.
You know, right now we're dealing with sickness, and we've really been kind of dealing with that since Carson Newman. Mia Long had strep throat then, and then, you know, we get into last week, we're at Catawba and LMU, and, you know, two of our kids had the flu, and then it bloomed to eight, and then, you know, Friday morning, I mean, we had four kids that would have been able to dress because everybody else was out sick. So, you know, kind of a unique stretch. I'm so used to always going, practice. So now you're getting ready to go into this gauntlet we're about to go into, and today we're going to get after it. But it's kind of uncertain what you're dealing with. But, you know, that's why you recruit mentally tough kids.
Right.
I think we've got a tough group, and you know, this stretch is going to be challenging. Like you said, I mean, we go to Carson Newman, we've got Mars Hill, we've got Wingate, we've got LR, who's playing really well right now, and then you finish it up, with Anderson,
yeah.
And then you go to Newberry. So definitely going to have our work cut out for us here down the stretch. But I told the girls is that the great thing about it is that they control their own destiny. And, you know, even to some of the returners, I told them, you know, it's a totally different feeling when you're playing in games that actually matter,
yeah.
Compared to games that don't matter. And so I'm proud of them that they've gotten us to this point, and now it's just about finishing strong.
A couple of kids just wanted to talk about just for a moment. Casey Johnson is number one because I think her role for this team changed just a little bit. You know, she's top 15 in scoring and rebounding in the league, mm-hmm. But I don't feel as if she has to. She's that person that's that huge mismatch because she can play behind three-point territory, where last year we had to keep her inside as a rebounding presence, mm-hmm. as well. You've got a five, you've got a couple of fives that you rotate. So how does that change Casey Johnson's game this year?
Well, I think it helps her because she's not having to play 38, 39 minutes a game. And then, you know, last year we depended on her so much for scoring, for rebounding, for everything, is that now we're able to sub her. We're able to get her a blow. And then obviously with our style of play, you know, she's able to be more efficient when she's on the floor. I was looking at her numbers the other day. I mean, her numbers are spectacular.
Yeah.
And, you know, with all that being said, she's our mismatch. She's our versatility player. I still think the best basketball is still in front of her.
Mm-hmm.
You know, with the addition of Kendria and Tori Patton and those girls, we're now able to play inside out with her a lot. And so we throw the ball down low, and then they're able to kick it back out to Casey, and she's getting wide open shots. And so, you know, I think that by the time she's done here, if she continues to work, she's going to be one of the best to wear the Pioneer jersey. And, you know, it's a testament to her hard work because she's also probably our hardest worker.
Your point guard position has always been key since you've been here, Shanice, Benny,
yep.
And now Mia,
yep.
A newcomer to your team. Second in the league in thievery. She's good in the steals, and she can score, and she can finish at the rim too.
Yeah.
13.4 points per game, you know, on the year. She's definitely changed things, no question about it. She's different from Shanice, and she's different from Benny, where I don't know necessarily where Shanice wouldn't always attack to the rim and she'd finish. She has the ability to go in with the bigs and finish, and I think that's a huge attribute.
Oh, for sure. I mean, I Mia Long was, when I watched her on film, she was the fastest girl I've ever seen. And no doubt, I knew that, you know, the style of play that, and you know, that I wanted to get to, and the style of play I wanted our program to be known for, you know, I knew we couldn't have kids walking the ball up the floor. And so when I saw Mia, I mean, she was a blur. And, you know, when she got here, you know, she got with Coach Klein from the start. In our strength conditioning program, she got stronger. I thought that was really big for her because she likes to go to the hole and she takes a lot of contact, and I knew she was going to be, you know, in the front of our press and do those different things. And so, you know, whereas before, I don't know if she could necessarily play the minute she's been playing, but now she's gotten used to that role. She's gotten stronger. You know, she's been serviceable even shooting the basketball. And so, you know, no doubt when she's on the floor, she makes us go because we're able to get more possessions. We're able to wear other teams down. And, I mean, she's a special talent. She's a special talent and a special kid. A
couple of kids. I just wanted to highlight a few more of these shows to go. We'll be highlighting others as well. It's a Pioneer basketball team that's getting ready to start a pretty tough stretch, especially on the road. We've got with Mars Hill. We're going to pack the arena for that night. And always a tough trip when you travel to Hartsville, South Carolina. And then you have to back that up by traveling to your arch rival, the Carson Newman Eagles. Those are the next games to come. As always, you can follow online through TusculumPioneers.com, and you can also follow by watching the home games, where you'll have our audio, the Pioneer Sports Network audio, just to clear some things up. When you go onto the schedule through TusculumPioneers.com and you click on live audio, for on the road, you're going to get the other team's live audio plus also their video. When we're at home, you get our video and our audio. But if you're on the road and want that live audio from the Pioneer Sports Network, instead of video, click audio. I know you guys want to watch it, but if you want to hear it, you'll hear it from our side of it. He's Pioneer Coach Devin Carter. I'm Brian State, and we're back next week with more Pioneer Basketball.